Hi, welcome to a preview of the Creative Whackpack app for iPhone. My name is Roger Von Eck and I created this innovation tool, and I'd like to take the next several minutes and share with you some of the key features and elements of this particular app. So why don't we just jump in right now? There's the icon. This product consists of 64 different creative thinking strategies, and let's take a quick look at some of them. These 64 strategies are divided into four 16-card suits. There are 16 explore strategies, and I'll scroll through these. And for example, here's one that says look to the past and give you a chance to see what the strategies look like. Each strategy has a headline. This is the strategy. In this case, look to the past, then there's a picture. And then you can click on the card and it tells a story or gives some examples of the strategy. For example, this one says, history is loaded with lessons that we can apply to current situations. Napoleon marching on Moscow is really just project management. Or Genghis Khan's rapid creation of the far-flung Mongol Empire shows the power of ruthless discipline combined with innovative tactics. And then you scroll down and the strategy, the card asks you, what ideas from history can you apply to a current project? And there's some other questions as well. But this is the model that I've used throughout, having the strategy, a picture of the strategy, some stories and examples, and then specific questions you can apply the strategy to a particular problem you have. So let's go back here now. So as I said, there are 64 strategies and they're divided into four suits. We looked at one of the explorer cards. How about the artist? There are a variety of artist strategies. Think like a kid, ask what if. Here's one of my favorites, be wacky. As I see it, there is a close relationship between the ha-ha of humor and the aha of creative discovery. And if you can laugh at a problem, perhaps you'll overturn some assumptions and come up with some fresh ideas. And again, there's an example, and then it asks you, what are some crazy, zany things you can do to the problem you have before you? And then I give some personal examples here. So let's get back though. And here are some of the other artist cards. Combine, make a metaphor, reverse, imagine you're the idea. And then there are 16 judge strategies. And these are some ways of thinking that you might apply when you're evaluating an idea, when you're deciding whether to implement this idea. Ideas such as see the positive, find what's out of whack, make sure you solve the right problem, ask a fool, one of my very favorites. Yeah, or another, here's another fool one, get out of the dogma house. And let's click on this. And this says, everyone has externally imposed shoulds and values that influence their thinking. And when these become dogmas, they can cloud your decision-making ability. And here are some examples, one from 2,500 years ago, one from 500 years ago, one 200 years ago, and some more recent ones. And then it asks you to apply this strategy to a problem. What dogmas are clouding your mind? How do they affect the way you view your issue? And then finally, there are 16 warrior strategies. And these are ideas you should think about when you're implementing an idea. Things such as take a whack at it, believe in yourself, put a line in your heart. 55, get rid of excuses. For example, you don't want to end up looking like this guy. And what does this one say? Well, think of an idea you had recently that you didn't execute. And what are some of the reasons you had? I didn't have the time. I couldn't sell it. I was afraid to fail. And there's some discussion of this, and then a story. And then it asks you to come to grips with this question. What three factors will make it difficult for you to reach your objective? So again, that's the model going on here. 64 different creativity strategies divided into explorer, artist, judge, and warrior suits. Let's go back to the home page. There's a whack of the day. This changes every 24 hours. Everyone on the planet gets the same whack of the day. And in this case, this one for today is reverse. And it says you can't see the good ideas behind you by looking twice as hard at what's in front of you. I find the whack of the day is a great way to wake up. It's often the first thing I'll look at, and it just gets my thinking going in a fresh direction. We'll go back here. If you want to, you can just get random whacks all you want. Here's one that says rearrange, push the that button, solve the right problem. And this, again, is a good way to get your thinking going in a different direction. But I believe the real value of this product comes when you use it on a particular issue in a creative workshop. And I'll go through this very quickly. But suppose you have a problem. Could be you're trying to improve sales. You're trying to think of ways to get your daughter to do her math homework. It could be you're trying to think of ways to raise money in a fundraising drive. Whatever problem you have, you might try a creative workshop and say, we're going to do the Four Suit Classic. And that means we're going to have four cards, one from each of the four suits. So let's see what we get here. Okay, look elsewhere. Well, again, we tend to look for ideas in the same old places, and this one says, you can't see the good ideas behind you by looking twice as hard at what's in front of you. So this gives some examples of people looking for ideas in other places. And again, I'm going through this very quickly, but you might spend 3 or 4 minutes in each card. Change its name. Click here. Different words lead our thinking in different directions and bring in different assumptions. Perhaps if we redefined our problem using different concepts, different words, it would open up our minds. Here's the judge card in this particular one. Loosen up. Great one. It's difficult to be creative if you've had too much ego tied up in an idea. And talks about loosening up. What can you take less seriously as you evaluate this? Think of an important standard you use to measure ideas. What would happen if you temporarily loosened that standard? And then finally, we'll get a warrior card here. And this is, hey, let's take a whack at it. You can't hit a home run unless you step up to the plate. You can't make your idea a reality unless you take a whack at it. And then finally, you get a summary. And these were the four strategies you got. So, again, I went through this in a minute, but you might take 5 or 10 minutes working either by yourself or with colleagues. And so there's other good information. I wrote a nice section on the creative process. Here's some of my background. That's me flipping a ball of wax. People like this product a lot, and I hope you take a whack at it. I think that you'll find it will put some fresh air in your thinking and help you look at the problems and issues before you in a fresh way. So I wish you good luck and happy whacking.